BioWare may be one of the most accomplished developers within this industry, delivering so many phenomenal games and franchises, from Baldur's Gate to Jade Empire, to Knights of the Old Republic, to Mass Effect, and to Dragon Age. BioWare truly has created some of the greatest video games ever. But in recent years, the BioWare many of us grew up loving has changed. Following the disappointment and mess that was Mass Effect Andromeda, many gamers just feel much different about modern-day BioWare. Certainly, there could be an argument made that BioWare changed even further back with games like Star Wars The Old Republic or Mass Effect 3 not having the universal acclaim that previous games in each franchise had received. You could also make the case, once the company's co-founders, the Doctors, departed from the company in 2012, things have been different since. Either way, like many companies nowadays, expectations and feelings have changed. But what's going on at BioWare is concerning, and it's the non-stop departures just in the last few years. All companies have turnover, but the sheer amount of notable veteran developers leaving mid-development is something that is a problem and something that we need to discuss. With Mass Effect Andromeda's development, BioWare lost the talents of senior development director Chris Wynn in December of 2015 and lead writer Chris Slurf in February of 2016. Very interestingly, they jumped ship right in the middle of development. Now, both Chris's downplay leaving, with Chris Wynn tweeting, "It is with a heavy heart today to say that I am moving on from BioWare and Mass Effect Andromeda and returning to the United States. I will join the passionate N7 community and will eagerly await the release of Andromeda with equal enthusiasm. The Andromeda team is the most talented team that I have worked with, truly inspiring to have worked with you each and every day." And additionally, Chris Slurf tweeting, "To confirm what some folks asked about a few months back, I am no longer working on Mass Effect Andromeda at BioWare Montreal. Sincerely, one of the best experiences of my career. I'm incredibly grateful to have worked with such talented and truly wonderful human beings. Think Mass Effect Andromeda is really going to blow people away, it certainly did. Couldn't be prouder to be part of it, and excited like a little kid to play the final when it's out." Now, no matter what, two veteran developers leaving mid-development was something many were talking about, and once we got closer to release, it was clear that the concerns were valid. Mass Effect Andromeda was not the game many expected, and unfortunately, with the game not meeting the expectations Electronic Arts had, they killed the BioWare Montreal branch. Other reports have followed since, just showing how much of a mess of a development this game was, with Kotaku's behind-the-scenes reporting on the many issues BioWare Montreal ran into, with one developer noting, "For the last few months of the game, we spent most of our effort just trying to keep it together rather than polishing. Just trying to stay ahead of how quickly it was falling apart." BioWare's next game is Anthem, an online multiplayer action role-playing title that looks very similar in many ways to Destiny. Many are excited for this game, but I personally am not excited. Maybe it's just my taste, but the gameplay does look like it could be fun. The world is certainly beautiful, but I've never really been into most multiplayer role-playing titles, and thus far BioWare barely has spent marketing or really much discussion on the actual story, which makes me at least feel that it might not at all be that important. Which wouldn't be much of a problem if this wasn't BioWare, a company who really has been all about amazing storytelling and role-playing. Additionally, BioWare has revealed there won't be romantic options and will have limited dialogue, which makes me believe this is a gameplay-focused experience. Either way, again like Mass Effect Andromeda, we're seeing some huge departures, with lead animator Stephen Gilmore leaving in November of 2017 after working at BioWare for 17 years. Writer Drew Karpyshyn leaving in March of 2018, I believe this was actually his second time leaving the company, but he is best known for being the lead writer on both Mass Effect and Mass Effect 2. And just the other day, creative director and lead designer of games that include Star Wars The Old Republic, Baldur's Gate 1 and 2, Neverwinter Nights, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, in Dragon Age, James Olin officially retired from BioWare. He had been working on Anthem, and as he stated on Twitter, "After 22 years I have retired from BioWare. I loved my time with Anthem, Star Wars, Dragon Age, and Dungeons & Dragons, but I need to take a break from the industry and work on something a little smaller and more personal." And this seems to be the trend, with a lot of BioWare veterans leaving the company, going on to work on smaller, I guess more personal things that they actually enjoy. But again, BioWare has lost more talent. Besides the Anthem and Mass Effect Andromeda departures I noted earlier, they've also lost Dragon Age writer David Gator, who had been with the company 17 years before leaving in January of 2016. Perhaps the biggest departure, though, came in October of 2017 with lead story developer for Jade Empire and Dragon Age creative director Mike Laidlaw departing from the company after 14 years. BioWare is is slowly losing their identity with each and every big veteran departure. At this point, I'm not really sure we can refer to BioWare as the same company anymore. In the same way, no one refers to Call of Duty Modern Warfare developer Infinity Ward as the same developer as they were in 2008. The real Infinity Ward lives on in Respawn Entertainment. But seriously, BioWare has become a shell of who they once were. At some point, maybe very soon, BioWare should just be referred to as EA Edmonton and EA Austin, because this company isn't the same as they were years ago when they were delivering hit after hit game. Anthem will tell us a lot about the future of BioWare, following the axe that was given to the Montreal branch after the mess that was Mass Effect Andromeda, and Dead Space developer Visceral Games being shut down late last year, right in the mid-development of their single-player linear Star Wars game. Many believe if Anthem fails, Electronic Arts may finally put an end to BioWare Edmonton. Electronic Arts is well known for killing game studios, and with FIFA and Madden ultimately being their money-making franchises, it's become clear that cutting costs and getting rid of studios that aren't financially successful is their philosophy. Either way, BioWare continues to lose many of the talented game developers that were responsible for making some of the greatest games ever made. But with this latest departure, my fears with Anthem are only increasing, and I really don't know if I care about the future of this company, as it seems BioWare isn't BioWare anymore, and that's disappointing. Anyway, what is your opinion on the numerous departures from BioWare in recent years? Do you think everything will be alright since Casey Hudson is back and in charge, or not? Casey Hudson has also downplayed some of these departures, but what do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. But thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like if you did enjoy this video or found any informative value, and also consider subscribing for more content like this, and I'll see you later.